What was the study and career path that led you to the forefront of fusion technology?
Second day of undergrad, I was really worried about how I would pay for school. So I went to the department chair and I said, who is paying for student undergrads to work in their lab? And so he gave me a list of professors that might be hiring. The first person that actually happened to be in their office studied fusion energy. And so that's the day I learned what fusion was. And so I got to see the lab. And when they said that you're using these magnets to confine the hottest thing you've ever thought of in the universe, it's kind of like confining jelly with rubber bands, I had no idea what any of that meant. I just knew it sounded fascinating. I got to use physics and math, and it would change the world. So that's the day I decided to go into this field. I think it's a great combination of my love of art and math and science, because I find a lot of beauty in math and in the universe. If you look up into the northern sky and you see the auroras, that's actually in the plasma state. So when I look up and I see the northern lights, I'm like, I can see all those plasma equations too. And I find that pretty cool and also beautiful. So I loved this combination.
I would like to ask you to talk a little bit more about math being pretty and the alignment between art and engineering and math.
You can just look at my notebook and you'll see it's beautiful. Like I did take all my notes in glitter pen and color pen, so that amplifies the beauty. But when I look into the universe, and you can observe it and say, wow, look at all these beautiful colors in the northern lights, right? And I can also look deeper and be like, look at those transitions of those electrons in the nuclei. They're going down and they're giving off this wavelength of light because of this transition and these elements in the sky. And I can also see the equations that go along with it. And I will just sit there and like think, you can think about what are these parameters in these plasmas? And then I have this whole sea of equations, and you can just simplify it. And then you're like, that equation right here is describing the universe. That's amazing.
That is incredible.